Welcome to Funnels YouTube channel, where I talk all things digital marketing, marketing data analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer. Today, I'm going to talk you through how to create a dashboard for Google Analytics 4 in Looker Studio. Now, I'm going to be using Funnel for this, and I'm going to show you just how easy it is in just a couple of minutes. So I'm gonna spend most of my time screen sharing, so let me just go ahead and show you. Alrighty, so the first thing you need to do here is you need to connect the data source. Now, I'm gonna be using demo data, but it'll be very similar for when you use yours. So I've got this here, Google Analytics. I'm just gonna turn on this. So first, I obviously need to choose Google Analytics 4. And I'm gonna go ahead and just choose the general SaaS GA4 Global. Go ahead and go with next. Next again. Next again, connect that data source. So that is downloading there. See, now that that's downloaded, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and go to Looker Studio. Alrighty, so now I get to this page, which is kind of, which report do I wanna use? I got a Facebook ads one, got a kind of integrated performance marketing one, YouTube, Shopify, Google Ads, and I want this one here, this Google Analytics 4 overview. I'm gonna go ahead and select that and press next. So it's checking that I've got that data downloaded. Perfect, it's downloaded. Go ahead and click next. And now I go ahead and click connect to Looker Studio. It launches that new window. There I go. Got myself a dashboard, right? So, alrighty. So first, there's just a couple of things on here for when you get in. If you're seeing broken widgets, don't worry. So if you've just joined Funnel, you've just signed up, your data's still downloading, so it could take a few minutes, but I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of that. As you can see here, this data controls the entire dashboard. Just letting you know, data in this dashboard is combined in Funnel from Google Analytics, so I'll just go ahead and get rid of that. And then just letting you know that we've used a selection of fields from Google Analytics that we choose for you. But if you wanna add more fields or remove fields or change the fields, you can go ahead and do that as well. You just need to kind of go back to your Funnel account, and there's a link there to back to your Funnel account. If I wanted to do that, if I go back to Looker, if I go back here, I go back to Explore Funnel, I can go to my data sources. Actually, I'll go to Data Explorer. I can kind of see here which fields I've got in from Google Analytics 4. But I'll go back to Looker Studio. Okay, so what have I got in here? I'm gonna leave this here because then you've got the link back to your Funnel account. So what have I got? I've got engaged sessions, perfect. I want to know how many people are on my site and are doing things that I want them to do, right? Engaged sessions, kind of the opposite of what bounce rate was in UA. I've also got an event value here. So I can choose whatever I want for this, but I took this event value metric. I could create custom metrics and choose whatever I wanted to display here as my kind of two most important metrics that I wanna see keep going in the right direction. So you see here, I've got a little trend in as well. So some tips for using the dashboard: select your date range, check out the chart, scroll down to the event exploration section, choose the most important event in GA4 and check out the charts, and then choose a session source to see the chosen event broken down marketing platform. Also super interesting. So super basic graphs here. I've got my sessions, which is the session event count, because it actually behaves much better than the actual sessions metric in GA4. So we use event count, session start. And then I can see here my sessions are trending in the right direction. Good, I'm doing my job properly as a marketer. And then I've got my engaged sessions here also following the kind of same trajectory. Then I've got sessions by campaign, so organic, CPC, referral, social, paid, etc. And then I've got sessions by medium, also something marketers kind of typically look at for something like GA4. Then I got this cool little area here, which we've called the event name and event count exploration. So what this means is I can sort of choose an event name and just look at that. So if I look at like signups on my blog, for example, again, this is demo data, but it's based on funnel events. So we're a B2B company, so our Google Analytics 4 events look a little bit different than if you're a kind of e-commerce. But I can see here, okay, now I can see the kind of trend of my blog signups. And I could just segment it by a specific campaign too if I wanted to. So I could go ahead and just choose only one of these campaigns to see, okay, how many blog signups do I have from this specific campaign? So if you're running some LinkedIn ads or some Facebook ads, you can go ahead and, all right, so I don't have any from this one in particular. But if I do a couple of these, this demo data doesn't always behave amazingly. But yeah, you can basically see, okay, how is this metric doing that I really care about from this campaign that I'm trying to get something out of, right? I'm trying to spend money on LinkedIn to try and get people to sign up for my blog, for example. You know, what's that relationship look like? So down here, you can see, again, it's demo data, so it doesn't behave perfectly, but you can see here that I've got my EMEA generic campaign, and I've got my EMEA UK campaign. They're bringing in the majority of my blog signups. But I can choose, you know, choose all of these again, and it'll give me the breakdown. It'll give me the breakdown here. There you go. And again, these charts, you know, once you input your data, you know, connect it to funnel, select this report, and you're kind of good to go with a template. You'll have all your data in there. This is just some information about the way funnel behaves with Looker Studio, just so you understand how it works. Again, if you want to add, remove stuff, you can go back to funnel. If you want to combine other marketing channels with your Google Analytics, it's really easy in funnel because we're not a plugin and the data doesn't go from, you know, straight from your platforms into Looker Studio. It's there stored in funnel. You can actually combine that data in funnel. So you can combine Facebook ads with Google ads with Google Analytics, and then you can create really powerful reports. If you're a B2B company, you can go ahead and connect your CRM as well. If you're an e-com, you can connect your Shopify. So you can kind of see the entire journey and really dig deep and really analyze that data and create some, you know, really kick-ass dashboards too. Again, if you got any feedback, go ahead, reach out to me personally. I've put my email here. So go ahead and do that. And then, yeah, if I just go back to funnel, just the last thing, if I go to Looker Studio, I just want to, you know, see, we've got a few templates in here. Funnel is incredibly flexible, but we also wanted to try and remove some of that complexity, right? We've got, you know, 2,000 plus customers using funnel in so many different ways, huge companies, medium-sized companies, small companies. But I really wanted to show how, you know, we really wanted to start making it a little bit easier for people to come in with a simpler use case, connect their data, and get that value really quickly. So get that template, get that data into that dashboard like that. So you can see here, Facebook ads, I've got all of these different options, and I can just go ahead and connect that data, and then I'm good to go. Alrighty, so that was it. I mean, I shared my screen for most of that, or you got a screen recording since this is YouTube, but that's how you can use funnel to get your data into a GA4 dashboard, template dashboard in Looker Studio in just a couple of minutes, and you can do it with any of your data sources. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe so you can get videos about digital marketing best practices, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.